Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's take a look at public photo streams. So back with Mobile Me, we had photo galleries and we were able to easily share photos with friends. But now with iCloud, we have public shared photo streams and we can just as easily share photos, not only from our Macs, but also from our iOS devices. So here I am in iPhoto on my Mac and I've turned on Photo Stream. That happened the first time I went to Photo Stream and it prompted me to turn it on. You can also go and check in Preferences under Photo Stream. Make sure you have it turned on and also make sure you've turned on Shared Photo Stream since we want to share some photos. Now I'm going to go to my photos here and I'm going to start a photo stream by first selecting some images. So let me select just the first three here and then I'm going to hit the Share button and I'm going to say I want to share using Photo Stream. Now I can share them to my photo stream. That's the normal photo stream that we've had since the beginning of iCloud. But what I want to do is I want to create a new photo stream. And here I can give some email addresses to some people I want to tell about this photo stream. I can name it and I can also check off to make it public. So now it's something that I can share with just sending somebody a URL. So let me hit share and it will create this photo stream for me. And if I look under web for photo stream, you can see I've got my photo stream there and I've also got the photo stream called sample photos. So let's take a closer look at that. I'm going to double click on that to select it and I can see information in here of which photos are there. I can also add comments to it by just clicking on this little comments button here. And I can also go back to the main photos here and I still have that information window selected. You can turn that on off by hitting info here and I can see that I've got a URL for that photo stream. So I can actually click on that and it will launch Safari and bring up that page with those photos. And I can now select this and copy and paste that URL into an email or post it on my website so anybody can go and view these photos. You can see here back in iPhoto there's also other things here I could change, like for instance the name and description of it. I can share with more by simply clicking in here and then typing other names of contacts or email addresses, and I can turn off the public shared setting for this photo stream if I want to. On the website here, if we dig down, I've added some more photos here, and let's click on a photo, we could see that we can play kind of as a slideshow. We can go back and forth between each photo. We can even download the photo there. And we can go to a full screen version of this while still all in the Safari browser. We can go back to the sample photos here and you can see that it's added them kind of in this pattern that it puts them there on the main screen, at least until you click on one to dig down and view them one by one. Now I can see here on my iPhone I'm viewing a picture here in the Photos app and I can hit the Share button and from there I can select Photo Stream and I get something very similar. I'm gonna using a different account here, but I can create a new photo stream, give it a new name and choose to have it on a public website just as before, or I can simply select a photo stream that is already there to add it to it. So you can do the same thing here on iOS. So public shared photo streams are a quick and easy tool to use. Both easy for you, there's really not many options, you should just create one and go, and also for the end user. It's very easy for them to view the photos and download if they want it. So it's a good quick photo sharing tool and it's just part of iCloud, so you probably already have it. Hope you found this useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. Want more video tutorials? Just go to MacMost.com, click on the videos link at the top of the page, and then you can view all of the hundreds of MacMost videos by category.